Hi everyone, this is Nkosinathi Sibeko. We're gonna be doing a video presentation. I can introduce my team here. This is O'Brien Sikahlane, this is Aliziwe Ngotwa, and this is Siyabulela Joseph. We're gonna be doing our pen tool video presentation, of which we're gonna go one by one on it.
Good day everyone. My name is Siyabulela Joseph. I'll be presenting about the Helican tool. This is the master tool for firefighters. Without this tool, they know. Here, what I'm going to show you here, the demonstration about the Helican tool. You can see this is a multi-purpose tool. You use this tool on opening doors, and then also the doors for vehicles, and also removing with this, removing a plank or a zinc on a bending shack. Here, what we're gonna do, and you can also use this Helican tool when to just to support on a to put a bonnet here on a car when it's maybe it's bending or you're working on it. This is how you use a Helican tool. You use this side to open the door. What you do, you put it in between the door and the frame. And then your partner will hit here the belt just to force it, and then you pull it open. Or you can also use it to break the lock. You can put it here inside. This side. Then you can put it here. You can put it flat here. And then also you can hit, and then you pull the side open. This is a throw bar. What we use this tool for, we use to remove nails. Also, you can use it to open the doors with this flat area here. How to use it, the throw bar? What you do, you force it in between the door and the frame. You can hit with a hammer here and then force the door open. That will be easy as that. Or you can also use it also on vehicles to open the doors from a vehicle, and also you do the same,
break the window.
You can also use it to break the window with it. Just hit it, the window of the vehicle, and make it open. Thank you. The other way to use the throw bar, you can use it to lift the door. How to use it? You take you put it underneath the door. There are doors sometimes we are with the hinges that you just lift it up and then it goes off. What you do, you lift the door up. If you see that it's difficult to do so, and then you can use a hammer or something that will assist.
Put it like that.
You see?
Two men. The one,
two men.
One also.
Someone to assist me here?
Okay.
Come this side.
No, like
that side.
Okay. What it does, and then you force the door up.
Yeah.
You see? It opens. It lifts up.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Go.
Okay. This is a bob cutter. It's a tool that you use to open the padlock, the chains. Also, the police does come to the fire station to open off the handcuffs. This is how you use this tool. Just have to open it, and apply a pressure, and then the lock will be open. This is the purpose of it. Thank you.
This is a car beryllium tool. This tool is used to cut the paving. You can use to cut the bricks, and also you can use to cut the cars when they are burning, or there is a patient inside. How to use this equipment? What do you do? You start it up, and then you hold it like this. Obviously, you're wearing what? PPE, helmet, gloves, also boots. You know, there's a protective gear also that you must wear. What you do? You cut through the bonnet straight up here. away from the ledge, and then you open it up, and then you can fire extinguisher the bonnet. What you do also, you can use here, you can also cut the vehicle. If you want to remove the bonnet up, what you do, you cut on it. A part, this is the A, B, and C part. But how you do it, you cut it from here on top, and also here, and also here. You cut it both sides, and then you remove the top of the vehicle, and then you can extract your patient. Or sometimes, if you want to remove the door, what you do, you cut the door from the inside. Those hinges, there are three hinges, and you cut them through with this beautiful tool. Thank you.
Go.
Okay, what I'm having now, it is a select powder that we use when there's when there's oil on the road. So we just throw it there, and then use our broom just to scatter the powder and top of the
go.
Okay, this is a spade and this is another broom. We use a spade to remove the debris, the sand, the grasses and everything. In case maybe there's a fire in a bush and a truck coming through the bush, when I take the sand and spray it over the fire. Also, sweep off the debris and the speed.
Okay, guys, this is a carboradium cutter. Okay, and we can also use this tool as to cut through the doors. Like when you get to the factory and you want to get inside, and then there's those steel gate doors, you can use this tool. See what we do with it? We make a triangle cut. We cut from here, down here, and from here to this point here, to make a triangle. Then we kick it in, so we can get in. We don't cut down here, just in case if you want to get in with the pipe, the edge of this thing doesn't cut the pipe. Thank you. Okay, guys, what I've got on my hands is called a chainsaw. Okay, this chainsaw, we use this one to chop trees into segments. Let's just say there's been a storm and the tree has fallen over the road and it's blocking the road. Obviously, if the tree is not big, we're gonna like remove it from the road. But if the tree is big, we're gonna chop it into small segments so we can just remove it off the road. And then in some cases, let's just say there's fire inside the tree, because some trees we find that they are holy. Then we want to extinguish the fire. But the thing is, the tree is tall, we can't get the water inside the tree. So we cut a small a hole in a tree, then we put water inside the tree to extinguish the fire. Thank you.
Okay, so now I have a bush beater with me. This tool, we use it when we're there to fight fire in the bush. And then when the truck does not, like when the fire is far, like 1 kilometer away, and then some people will just go there and use this thing to fight the fire. So basically we use it like this. Like you have to be fast when using it, because you are waiting to blow the air with the wind that comes from the beater. So you have to be fast like this. Thank you.
Okay, this is a garden fire. This is a garden fork. We use it if maybe there's a rubbish that is spinning and the water can't reach to the fire, so we use this garden fork to remove those rubbish. So in order for the water to reach the fire. Thank you. Okay, these are shack hooks, in case there's a fire in a shack and the plates are too hot in a way that you can't remove them with your gloves. So this is how you use them. Apply it on a plate, you remove it. Apply it on a plate, you remove it up until you see the fire, and you can put on a fire extinguisher or water in order to destroy that fire. Thank you.
This is a stage hammer. This is what we use to break the doors. We can use it in conjunction with the Helican tool. When you open the door, to hit the Helican tool. Also, you can break a window with this. We can use it on breaking the windows. And also with this tool, what you can do, you can use to break big doors if it's possible, if you don't have those Helican tools. And thank you again. This is a Pryx tool. This is a mini version for Helican tool. Just having a hex part here, you can see where you can hit also the window, and then also you can also drag the shack zinc just to hit it and then drag it. This is also a multi-purpose tool, like a Helican tool also. That's why they call it a mini Helican tool. You can also open the doors, force it through, and then you can open the doors. Thank you.
Okay. This is a hacksaw. You use it to cut steel in case one of the machine that we use fail. We use it to cut the cars, the APC point, in order to expose the patient or do whatever you wanna do in a car, and you don't have the equipment to do it. So this is a manual one that you use each one. Thank you.
Okay, what I have with me is called the hydraulic cutter. Okay, basically this piece of machine here can cut through anything. It can be the doors, steel, but we mainly use it on the road, like to cut through the cars. When you want to remove the roof of the car, you cut from point A, B, and C, then we move to the other side and we cut also on A, B, and C, then we remove the roof of the car. Thank you. Okay guys, now I'm gonna go through all the tools that we covered through our presentation. Okay, the first one here on my right, right there, it's called a bush beater. Okay, as Ali explained earlier, we use this one to put out the fire. And this one right here, it's a crowbar. Okay, we use this one to break into the building, like the doors, and then break into the cars and stuff like that. And this here is a bolt cutter. Okay, we use this one to cut chains. And then we said this one is a Helican tool. It's a multi-purpose tool also. We also use it for breaking in. And then right here, you've got a sledgehammer. Okay, we usually use the sledgehammer. We can use it for bringing down the walls or breaking down the doors sometimes. But in most cases, we use this one in conjunction with this Helican tool here if you want to break it. Here, that I have with me is a breaking in axe. So what we do with this one, you can use this one to chop down the trees, or you can use this one to break the windscreen of a vehicle.
Okay.
And this here is a Pro-X, the mini version of the Helican tool. It's also a multi-purpose tool, like Joseph explained it, how to use it. You can use this side to break in, to break the door. You know, you just slide it in there, in between. Then you twist it. And this is a 4-pound.
You don't think Selfie's like my daughter? My daughter's like this.
Okay, and here, these are the shack hooks. Like Mr. Sbego explained how to use this one. And this one here is a hacksaw to cut through steels. This is the garden floor. And then here we've got our spade, like we explained how to use this one to extinguish the fire. And here we've got our dry powder.
Okay, we'd like to thank Mr. Maharshi, which is the senior of the Bobo fire station, and Mr. Phillips, who was our director.